Hi, this is CADCAM Lessons channel, and this is another part of the guide where I discuss the basics of FreeCAD. FreeCAD is a completely free 3D CAD system where we can create our own 3D models. And in previous parts, I covered the basics of creating 3D models in FreeCAD. And in this part, I will briefly discuss the user interface. After starting FreeCAD, we have a start window where recently used files are displayed. And the number of recently displayed files can be adjusted in the preferences. Here is the path to where we specify the number of recently used files. Now let's move to the top menu where we have the standard file edit view menus. Regarding the file menu, it is the standard menu where we open or save projects. And in the subsequent drop-downs menus, we have various options. These menus can change depending on the selected module. And for modules, we have a list here. After expanding this menu, we have a list of available modules. And so far, we have been working in the part design module. Simply selecting this module brings up additional commands. For example, in the part design menu, there are commands used in the part design module, and these commands in the drop-down menu are also available as icons. Sometimes an icon may not be available or visible, but we can find the command in the part design menu, and it should be accessible there. We will return to this shortly. Here we have a combo view. When I start a new project, tasks appears, and the first task is create body, which is what we discussed in one of the first parts of the tutorial. However, usually while working with FreeCAD, we use the model tab where we have the operation tree showing the operations used to create the 3D solid. When we create a sketch or add an operation, it all will be in the operation tree. And below we have the property window showing the properties of individual feature in the operation tree. We will use this in later parts of the tutorial. Now let's return to the icons. And as you can see, most commands are available as icon, but sometimes these commands may not be available or visible. To enable or disable commands as icon, right click here and enable or disable the selected icons. For example, I disable the workbenches and now I cannot select a workbench. I'll re-enable it here. Okay. And the position of these icons can be changed by dragging them to any point on the toolbar. Or they can be dragged outside the toolbar. Okay. I'll put them back here. Okay. And sometimes beginners ask why an icon is invisible or unavailable on the toolbar, and it's likely that one of the icon set is not enabled. But as I mentioned, commands available as icons are also available in the drop-down menu. We can select commands from this menu as well. Now let's go to the edit menu and select preferences. And sometimes there are questions about how to change the background color. And changing the background color is simple. Go to the display and here select colors. And here we have section background color. And here you can select simple color and you can choose a background color. And background color is changed. I'll switch back to linear gradient. Okay. And another way to change colors is by changing the theme. You can select one of three themes, classic, dark, or light. And for example, I'll choose dark theme, click apply, and we have the dark theme. If you prefer working in this theme, you can activate it here. If you prefer the light theme, select it, click apply, and the light theme is active. If you prefer the classic theme, select it, and this theme is active. And another annoying aspect for beginners is the report view, a window at the bottom that often pops up with red text suggesting something is wrong. Sometimes the information there is useful, but it often causes unnecessary confusion. Therefore, I usually disable the report view by default. I have disabled the options to show the report view on error, warning, on normal message, or on log message. And for most beginners, this information is unnecessary, but if you want to see it occasionally, you can enable the report view from the view menu. I'll close the preferences, and you can open the report view from view, panels, report view. And the information will appear here. I will start a new sketch, and I'll create a solid. Okay. And I'll provoke some error. Okay. And we have an error because FreeCAD doesn't allow such actions, and we will cover this in later parts of the tutorial. However, this warning doesn't provide much information to a beginner. The information after clicking OK is more helpful, and it means that creating multiple solids in one body is not supported. This warning gives me actionable information, and at the beginning of learning FreeCAD, this type of message can cause unnecessary confusion. Therefore, I usually disable the report view. Okay, and basic principles of creating 3D models in FreeCAD will be discussed in one of the following parts of the tutorial. In this part, I wanted to briefly present basic issues related to the user interface. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to this channel.